solo sessions about a year ago, and what I gained from it was profound. New ideas, new insights into the future. It was just excellent. So I have developed an application or a program that you might like to call it. And it's AI and ML through game simulation. So I have developed this application on Unity. And this is a small little milestone that I'd like to share with you. So in here, this is an asset that I've uploaded on Unity. It's called Artificial Intelligence and Machine Learning Prototyping Kit. It is an algorithm that dynamically learns to follow and get followed. We're talking about a few cars here. So two cars, one controlled by me, and the other controlled by the codes I've been running.
Learns to follow who?
Yes, the
car. Learns to follow who? Learns to follow who?
Learns to follow who? Another object, which is either my car or itself.
Okay,
so it learns to follow and get followed. So these are two cars we're talking about. It captures the driving pattern of the cars of the user to decide on its own path and movement, and keeps within the parameters that we have set for a car. Then it has certain real life applications. We're not going to go too deep into it because there's a time constraint. So now you would say, Sacha, this is just like a self-driving car. What's there to it? So by definition, a self-driving car is capable of sensing its environment and navigating without human input. Now in here, in this model, it is not only able to do all of the above, it is also able to get chased by a human-driven car and find the shortest possible way out dynamically and efficiently, while also predicting the next move of the user's car.
Self-driving car. Sorry, can I ask a question later?
Okay.
How is it different from autonomous cars?
Yes, so
so what is the difference?
There is a difference that this is not only able to navigate without human input, it is also able to get chased by a car. It gets chased, and all of this is basically on machine learning. So there's a short video to it. I'll just come back in a second to the video. So what runs behind the scene? There are certain strokes involved. Of course, genetic algorithm and neural networks form the basis of this project. There is car suspension so that you don't have any jerky movements. Then car AI control. This is coupled with sensors and basic movement in order to get the car around the scene. And the camera. Here, camera plays a very important role. This is also very helpful in debugging the program. And where exactly and how exactly the algorithm is running. So the camera processes, it doesn't process, it gives me the output so that I can correct the error. Then there is a flow strip that we're going to talk about in the future slides, and there's a waypoint tracker to map the waypoint. Now, I returned all the log files, and what I got was a coordinates. And here I map the coordinates on Excel. As you can see, on the graph, I have the blue car, I'm controlling the blue car, and the red car is the AI car. Now you can see that it's the shortest possible distance. We start from about here. Go on to there, and I'm still not able to change the car, and it's about 16-17 units away from me. So it has started from this distance and expanded this distance. Of course, I'm faster than the car just to test its speed. And we have some missing data points over here. That was because of an error. This was the follow AI, and this was the inverse chase AI. I'm chasing the AI car. So that itself is a huge thing. Then this is the basic follow AI pattern. In here, I have the blue car, and this finds the shortest possible curve to intercept me over there. So at this point in time, it catches me. This has gone through about 17 iterations, And here's a video. I'll pause here to put in the video. So this all seems really complex, but it's really simple. Here's a hierarchy. Here's the scene manager, human, AI, all the sensors over there, that's the inspector's menu, and you have all these scripts attached to it, waypoint progress tracker, C suspension, genetic algorithm, and neural networks, and even the sensors, and it's dynamically moving, as you can see here. These are all the raycast hit points, as in where it's going, how it's doing all this stuff. Here is the basic model, the aerial view of how that truck is operating.
What is your level of involvement with all this? Are you directly involved in all this?
Directly involved. All the code has been written by me, and in fact all the models have also been made by me in Blender. I imported some standard scripts too. So and here it kind of shows some intelligent behavior. This is a 17 declaration, but right here are the scripts. So all the scripts are elaborated are over here. This is the genetic algorithm script, and here this is for commercial purposes. So here I have to explain that the scripts are commenting, so you can easily change your tune. This is the neural network script right here, and there are some really the code, the learning curve of this code is, in my opinion, it couldn't have been better. Because I, while I was coding, I went through breakthrough. And I saw this bias neuron was doing most of the job. So I highlight the neural network, the bias neuron. Here we have the sensor script, so the standard processes. And then the follow AI. Here comes a really interesting thing. Right, so it starts from here. This is again the 17th iteration in which it breaks through it. It's directly following. Of course it's faster than me, otherwise how will it catch me? And I'm trying my best to steer out of its path. But the path it's taking is the shortest, and in my opinion, it's the most efficient. It is more efficient than humans can drive. And in a little while, it is going to intercept me. Somewhere around here. I recorded this video a few months back, so yep, right here. Here it goes. Generation 17, total brightness. All the neural network output is written over there. So,
how many layers are there?
It was customized, can't remember, but.
But how many say? 10, 20, 30, how many? 5?
I think it was, no. It was about 20, 5,
25. Yeah, that could be fairly complex.
It was very complex. And coming back to this, so where am I headed with this project? So adding to the benefits of self-driven cars, this demonstration is capable of mapping how cars are driven in the real world, how the cars are driven. Then with these dynamic data inputs, learning becomes much more efficient and the ability to avoid disaster increases. Remember the earlier code script that we were talking about? With reaction proximity, the car can learn how to act in situations that involve action to be initiated within a split second. So you have a car which is speeding by and you really need to brake, and in a split second you hit the brake, there you go, you averted a disaster. Inverse AI feature. Inverse AI feature can also be accommodated when an incoming traffic which is already being done. Accommodated when an incoming traffic is sensed or an incoming storm, not here in India, but incoming hurricane or any natural disaster is sensed, which brings me to my last point. Not only are you on the fastest route, but you're on the most efficient and the safest route. This project was recognized globally, and on the Unity Asset Store, on the official store, this was in the top page, in the top three right here. It was the latest and the ongoing asset. It was listed in the top most throughout the whole store. And there is a third party website called Unity Bus. So that right there is the Unity Bus, and it was ranked fourth globally. It maps around 5,000 assets, so it was ranked fourth on a